Hello, welcome back once again. In the previous tutorial, we had completed the conditional statements in PHP. In today's session, we are going to learn arrays in PHP and looping statements. So as you know that array variables are a special variable which can store multiple values in a single variable. So these are the some of the theoretical topics which you already know. So let us directly jump to the practicals. There are three types of array available in PHP: numerical array, associative array, and multidimensional array. Let us see the practicals of each. So first of all, simple array. This is the output of simple array program. Let us see the code for that. This is an array variable, simple variable like other PHP variables, preceded with the dollar sign, numbers, and then keyword array, bracket, and inside that values of array variable. This is an integer variable. Yes. Similarly, if you want to create the string variable, then we can create the string variable also. This is a second method to create the array. We will see this later on because we are going to print this using the looping statement, which we will see very soon in this tutorial only. So if you want to print this value, then we can use this statement to print the array variables. Simple, this is function to print the array variable. Like echo variable, we can use this print underscore r statement also to print the array variable. Simple, we have to pass the array variable name over here and it will print the array like this. So on 0th index, value is 10. We can see over here, array index start from 0, on index 1, 20 value, 2, 30, and likewise on 4th index, 50 value. So total 5 element, and we can use the using print underscore r statement, index as well as value of the array. So this is a first program of array. Second program is multidimensional array. So we can print the multiple dimensional array in this manner. Let us see the code first. This is a two dimensional array, cars. Similar keyword array is used inside braces and end with the semicolon. First array having value Volvo, string value, second dimension and third dimension of this first index of this main array cars. The second index, that is index 1, is having these three values. Third index, that is index number 2, is having these values. So this is a two dimensional array, each dimension having three dimension like this, and we can print it using array echo variable like this, $cars 00, that is refers this Volvo, then static string message, then $cars 01, that refers this element, and then 02, that refers this element. Likewise, 10 refers this. Likewise, 11, 12, 20, 21, 22. And the output of this is like this. Volvo ordered 100, sold 96. Likewise, we can print the multidimensional array using echo statement using this syntax. So this is the example of multidimensional. Associative array. Now associative array is something different in PHP. Let us see this in code. Let us say I print this array variable ages, and array associative array stores the value in the pair of key and value dimension. So parse is a key and value is 20 for that. Same way Amit is a second key and its value is 21. Similarly, Dhawal is a third key and its value is 20. Now, if I want to print this, I can print it using print underscore r dollar ages, and if I want to print separately this key value only, then I can print using echo statement dollar ages, and this is a ages is a array variable. This is a index of this array variable, that is Amit, and age is a value of that index Amit. So it is having 21 age, so it is going to print like this. Let us print that associative array. So array parse is having value 20, Amit having 21, Dhawal having 20, and this is the output of this echo statement. Now if I want to print it in the new line, then I have to simply write down br tag and concat it with the, so that we can differentiate between the two, print and echo statements output. So this is the associative array. As I've said, this is something new in PHP, associative array. In associative array, each value is associated with a key, and that key can be a string also. So I had associated a Amit string with this age value 21 and print the same. If I want to associate Paras string, then it will print the age associated with this key. Let us rerun. So as we see that Paras is associated with 20 value, so it is print the value 20. So this is it, this is the concept of arrays. Now let us move forward to the concept of looping statement, PHP loops. So there are four type of loops: while, do while, for and for each loops. Let us see all this loop in programming construct. So similar, do statement and blocks that are going to executed inside do, we are going to print the value of dollar variable a. We are incrementing each time a variable, and once the a value is greater than 5, the do while variable completes. Do while loop is going to be complete, and the output of this is, it is printing the value of a variable starts from 0 0 1 2 3 4. Once the value is going to increment and become 5, 5 less than 5 is false, and thus the program gets terminated. So this is the do while loop. Next loop that we are going to see is for loop. For is also going to print the same value. Let us see the different in the syntax only. Starts from 0, condition, and then increment. So I variable is going to be start with 0, it increments regularly and print the value of I until the value becomes less than 5, and we are terminating each echo statement with new line so that we can see the output in the new line in the browser. So this is a simple for loop. Let us see while loop first of all, because for each loop is somewhat different in this case. While loop is also similar like other programming statements. Starts I from 0 until the value of I becomes less than 5. We are printing the value of while loop, and this is the output. Let us see the for each loop is somewhat different than the other loops. Let us, we have say store some of the values, string values inside this array, stay safe at home. So as the COVID-19 is there, I had take the relative example inside this. So inside for each loop, first element is the index variable, the array variable $list. Then as keyword, and then over here user defined element variable $list_element. You can write any variable over here. Whatever variable you will write after as, that variable is going to be fetch the value from the array list. So we are printing this statement echo and list element which we have defined over here inside for each loop. So $list, let me repeat once again, $list is an array variable, and as $list element is a variable used to fetch the array value, and that is going to be print inside this echo statement and completed and terminated with the break statement. Let us save and run this program. So after running that, whatever content of array list is going to be print over here. If I change the variable over here like var1 and print, then it will show me undefined variable. Since I am using in for each loop var1 and printing someone another variable inside each echo statement, so that is not allowed. So I have to use var1 variable only. Let us rerun. Now it is giving me the correct output. So these are the loop which we have, which we are using in PHP. Let us go back to older program of array. Inside array, I said that temporary we are skipping this program. Let us make it effective, because now we had learned the for each loop concept. If you want to print this array using for each, then we can use this construct. Let us say I had, let us first of all make this in a commented statement, because this is not a PHP statement, this is only a second method to create an array. This is a first method that we have already seen. If you want to create variable dollar number in this manner, then also it is allowed. And if I want to print this array variable, then I have to print using for each. First of all, array name $numbers and user defined variable value. So we are printing the value of that variable over here, $value. Let us see the output of that. So value is 2, 3, 4 and 5, whatever value is there over here inside the array variable. If I make the change and 5, then respective change is made inside this. So that's it. In today's session, we had learned array and looping constraint in PHP. See you in the next tutorial.